Hi, I'm Dr. Rajdeep. I'm a dermatologist and dermatosurgeon practicing at Charma, JP Nagar, second phase, Bangalore. When the skin starts looking lighter than the surrounding skin, we call this as hypopigmentation. When it looks darker, it's called as hyperpigmentation. So hyperpigmentation is often just simply referred to as pigmentation. So many patients come and say, I have pigmentation. So that is darkening of the skin. Hypopigmentation is lightening of the skin, and there are various conditions which can cause hypopigmentation. One of the common conditions which causes hypopigmentation is called vitiligo. In fact, in this condition, it's not just hypopigmentation, entire color is lost. So we call it as depigmentation. The other conditions which can cause hypopigmentation, in children we have conditions like pityriasis, alba. There is of course an infectious condition which is fortunately not very common these days, thanks to the government programs which have helped to almost reduce it to a large extent. This condition is called leprosy. So leprosy, you might have seen people losing their fingers and toes, and they lose sensations, they get ulcers, etc. So leprosy starts off as hypopigmented or light colored patches on the skin. There are other rare conditions like paraproriasis and mycosis, fungoides, etc., which can cause hypopigmentation, and these are more serious conditions which can be early stages of skin cancer. So usually hypopigmentation is nothing dangerous, nothing to be worried about, and it's treated by a machine called as phototherapy machine. A smaller version of this phototherapy machine, which treats smaller areas with much higher energy, is called as targeted phototherapy. So because targeted phototherapy gives higher energy, it requires lesser sessions and the results are faster. There are also phototherapy machines which treat the full body. So they are called as full body phototherapy machines, but the energy produced is lesser and more scattered. So how does this phototherapy work? Usually it uses UV light and the UVB range, and targeted phototherapy sometimes uses lasers which produce a particular wavelength, usually 308 nanometers. Whereas other larger phototherapy machines produce a narrow band of UVB light. So they're called as narrow band UVB chambers. So this activates the melanocytes. This particular wavelength activates the melanocytes and makes the melanocytes start producing the pigment melanin, which helps in repigmenting. But if your melanocytes are completely destroyed or completely inactive, even phototherapy will not be able to repigment the skin. So usually treatment for about 2 to 3 months reveals whether these melanocytes are active or not. And if it's not active, melanocytes from other areas can be grafted onto the affected area, and then phototherapy can be restarted. To know more about this, contact a dermatologist near you.